Hello everyone, welcome in my Electro-Instrumentation channel. Today I am going to discuss about continuity test and basically continuity test of a cable. So first of all, we have to understand what is continuity test and why do we do continuity test and how we do continuity test. All these questions I am going to discuss today. So first of all, we have to understand what is continuity test. A continuity test is a quick check to see if a circuit is open or closed, because only a closed or complete circuit will give continuity. Basically, continuity is a closed path for a current flow. So during continuity test, this digital multimeter will send a very small current through the closed circuit to measure the resistance in the circuit. And as we know that in any circuit, if that is closed, means there is a very small or negligible resistance is there. So if the value is coming around 20 or 50 ohm, that is acceptable. That is acceptable. This our continuity is good. But if it is more than that, it means that there is something fault in our cable or any equipment we are testing. So we will do the practical by this multimeter we are having. We are also having the cable, this cable. I am going to test the continuity test of this cable. I am going to do that. Friends, more often we get around 1 or 2 ohms resistance when we do the continuity test of this cable or any cable. We will get only around 1 or 2 ohm. So we are going to test this cable. For that I am going to remove its insulation and make the core out. Friends, before going to do the continuity test, first of all I am going to check this multimeter is working or not. For that I am going to turn it on and put in the continuity. Yeah, now this is set. Now if I'll touch this and the sound will come, it means, see, if the sound is coming, it means the path is closed and it has very low resistance. That's why the sound is coming, the buzzer sound is coming. So if the path is get closed, having a very low resistance, the sound will come. In this way we are going to test the cable also. See, we also, friend, understand this. See this certificate, this is calibrated from the Ricky company, okay, and it has calibration date 18 March 2022. Okay, it is calibrated, this multimeter is calibrated, okay, so it is good and certified. Friends, this is the multimeter, digital multimeter. It is off. Now I am going to move this knob towards the continuity test settings. This is this point you are seeing. This is the sign of continuity test. Okay. So from this multimeter, I am going to test this cable. That insulation I have removed just now. So I am going to do the continuity test of this cable from this multimeter and we will see what happens. Friends, I have insulated this cable and just I have connected this black knob of multimeter with the white lead of this cable and this black with the red knob. Okay, I have already connected. So I have sorted this from the multimeter. This is the one end of the cable and the second end I am going to short it and let's see what happens. See, as I am closing this, as I am shorting this, the sound is coming from the multimeter. Or what multimeter is showing? See, 1.7 ohm it is showing the resistance. So it is very low resistance. It means this cable is good and there is no continuity lag. So if I am, see, if I am the opening this the circuit, the sound has stopped. Okay, the buzzer sound is stopped. And again, if you can check, as I am shorting it, the sound is coming. Removing, sound stop. Shorting it, sound, as I am shorting it, sound is coming. Removing, sound is stopped. So this is the way to test the continuity test. This is the continuity test we do. Friends, I am having this. This is a electrical cable. This is 4 core cable. See, I have insulated it from both sides and see the settings of this multimeter. So if I'll touch the other end and check whether it is giving the continuity sound or not. So let's check. See, here I have connected black and red. Black and red I have connected with this probe of the multimeter. I have connected already connected with the cable. One side I have connected and one side I am doing the open and close and check it is showing the continuity or not. If this, see, if the path is closed, I am closing it, the sound is coming and it is showing 1.4 ohm. So it is very low, means it, our cable is good and continuity is okay. Removing, the sound has stopped. Again, see, if I am shorting it, the sound is coming. So this is the way to do continuity test. Friends, we have done the continuity test of cable. So what is the purpose of this continuity test? So it has some purpose, no? That's why we are doing the continuity test inside the plant. From the international wiring regulation, friends, it is mandatory to test any equipment or cable before installation and after installation, before putting it to in services. So it is very important to test the cables or equipment if we are going to use in service. So friends, continuity is a very important test to determine any damaged components or broken conductors in a circuit. If the resistance is too high to flow a current, it means there is any broken conductor from the inside or any fault between two points. And if we are testing any cable and it is showing that it is a continuous shorting, it is showing, it means that also there is some fault inside the cable or it is internally shorted. So these things we determine by the continuity test. Actually, if we are talking about in plant, we are pulling a bundles of cables or a bunch of cables we are pulling. So how we know about that, which cable is for what purpose? We used to pull from the trench, conduit and also from the tray. Many cables we used to pull. So for the identification purpose also, we do the continuity test to identify this is the cable we have pulled for these purposes. So from that point of view also, it is very important to ensure the identity of the cable.